Gegap gempita penyelenggaraan APEC juga dirasakan warga Bali.
Mudah-mudahan dengan adanya APEC ini ada perubahan yang saya harapkan terutama dari Bali, terutama dari travel agent yang terutama ada di airport, seperti saya ini istilahnya walk-in guest, supaya dapat cipratannya sedikit saja gitu loh.
Ya, Bali mungkin lebih dikenal di mancanegara, dalam tentunya dalam pelaksanaan event-event kenegaraan, dan ada income pemasukan buat masyarakat Bali tentunya.
Sangat positif sekali ya Pak ya, apalagi kita di Bali ini menjual jasa yang namanya kita di transportasi. Biasanya selain kita ada acara-acara penting di Bali, ini akan meningkatkan segala jenis kayak transportasi, ekonomi di Bali semakin meningkat. Ini setara dengan kita itu iklan, ibarat itu promosikan Bali di ajang internet.
Nah, jadi harapan ke depan biar masyarakat Indonesia, khususnya masyarakat Bali, bisa memahami jadi Bali terpilih sebagai tempat untuk pelaksanaan KTT APEC ini. Jadi biar pandangan dari mata dunia itu bisa lebih diyakini, dipercaya lagi oleh negara-negara di Indonesia, negara-negara di dunia ini, bahwa Bali betul-betul aman.
Ini akan membawa dampak yang sangat positif bagi Bali, bagi Indonesia, dan even saya katakan tadi bagi dunia ya, karena di sini dibahas berbagai hal yang menyangkut ekonomi yang seringkali up and down, yang juga dipengaruhi oleh banyak hal, politik, environment dan sebagainya. Jadi itu penting sekali ya, dari segi substansinya saja sangat penting, dari segi dampak positifnya ya, nilai positifnya banyak sekali. Saya kira kalau Bali sukses menjadi host ini, nama Bali makin moncer di dunia.
Kami dari Telkom Group, bukan hanya Telkom, di situ ada Telkomsel, di situ ada anak perusahaan yang lain, memiliki komitmen yang tinggi bahwa infrastruktur sekelas APEC ini adalah sebenarnya infrastruktur yang kelas dunia, dan memang menjadi sebuah cita-cita Telkom untuk bisa di-deliver kepada pelanggannya dimanapun.
Dalam jamuan makan malam kenegaraan pada Senin 7 Oktober 2013, Presiden dan Ibu Ani Yudhoyono mempersembahkan rangkaian tari dan nyanyian yang mewakili Indonesia maupun selera internasional. Kelancaran APEC 2013 ini juga ditunjang oleh Komando Gabungan Pengamanan yang bekerja keras menyeimbangkan antara keamanan yang ketat dan kenyamanan tamu negara, turis maupun warga setempat.
Beliau menjabarkan, menyampaikan sebagai suatu petunjuk perencanaan bahwa pengamanan itu harus ketat, tetapi tidak overacting dan memberikan kenyamanan. Nah, saat kita berbicara antara secureness dan comfortable, ya, secureness dan comfort, maka disitulah kejelian kita sebagai aparat keamanan untuk memberikan rasa aman dan juga rasa nyaman.
Pada hari kedua penyelenggaraan APEC Leaders, Presiden SBY menerima kepala-kepala negara kawasan Pasifik bersama para pemimpin ekonomi APEC. Pertemuan ini dilanjutkan dengan retreat meeting kedua untuk merumuskan hasil akhir APEC 2013. Presiden SBY menutup rangkaian acara puncak APEC 2013 ini dengan membacakan 7 kesepakatan bersama para pemimpin perekonomian di kawasan Asia Pasifik.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Om Swastiastu. Peace and prosperity to us all. Members of the media, ladies and gentlemen, we have just concluded the 21st APEC Economic Leaders Meeting, which I chair. I am pleased to say that our summit went on successfully and was indeed very productive. In the course of 2 days, we discussed thoroughly
the central theme of APEC 2013, Resilient Asia-Pacific, Engine of Global Growth. After our intensive deliberations, and needless to say, the whole year-long discussion among our officials, we agreed on a number of strategic points. Let me now highlight 7 of them. First, we agreed to redouble effort to attain the Bogor goals in 2020. We shared the views that all the APEC economies must continue to gain from the APEC cooperation. In line with this commitment, we agreed to take further steps in empowering, engaging, and opening opportunities for all stakeholders to participate in the APEC process and gain benefits from it. Second, we agreed to increase intra-APEC trade or intra-region trade, including through trade facilitation, capacity building, and the functioning of multilateral trading system. This reference to the multilateral trade systems is a recognition that although the promotion of such intra-APEC trade cooperation brings concrete benefit to the APEC economies, the success of the multilateral regime remains very critical. In this regard, we have agreed on a declaration which supports the multilateral trading system. We also agreed to ensure the success of the upcoming 9th WTO Ministerial Conference in Bali in December 2013. Third, we agreed to accelerate APEC's physical, institutional, and people-to-people connectivity. In this regard, we envision a strategic landscape for connectivity in our region through the development and investment in infrastructure. We shared the views that connectivity could help reduce the production and transportation costs, strengthen regional supply chain, and improve business climate in the region. And at the same time, infrastructure and connectivity building will create more jobs and ensure job security. Fourth, we reaffirm our commitment to achieving a strong, balanced, sustainable, and inclusive global growth. In the process, we agreed to facilitate the enhanced participation of small, medium, and micro-sized enterprises, youth, and women entrepreneurs. These SMMEs are the backbone of our country. Fifth, in view of the scarcity of our finite resources, we agreed to cooperate in enhancing regional food, energy, and water security. This effort is also aimed at responding to the challenge of population growth and the adverse impact of climate change. At this Bali Summit, we began to look at this matter in a holistic manner. Sixth, we agreed to ensure APEC synergy and complementarity with other multilateral and regional processes, such as East Asia Summit and G20. This is essential as our world is marked by multiple architectures of economic partnership. And seven, we agreed that close collaboration with the business sector through APEC is essential to achieve the objective of a free and open trade and investment. Close collaboration will result in a win-win situation, especially at the time when the global economy has yet to fully recover. Now that we have all these agreements and commitments, we must show to the world that APEC will continue to play a significant role in global economy. I believe that all APEC economies will share responsibility to live up to these commitments.
Finally, I would like to express my sincere thanks and appreciation to all the leaders and their delegation for the continued support during Indonesia's APEC chairmanship. I thank everyone who has made the summit a success, APEC, business delegation, the APEC Secretariat, and of course the organizing committee. In particular, I would like to thank the people of Bali for their extraordinary support and hospitality. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Usai sudah penyelenggaraan APEC 2013 di Bali, para pemimpin perekonomian, delegasi, maupun media pulang ke negara masing-masing. Mereka akan bertemu kembali di Beijing tahun 2014.